Now, new at 5, we're learning more about a climate change plan for the city of Columbus. It comes as climatologists predict more flash flooding and higher temperatures because of climate change.
Meteorologist Rachel Penton joins us now live with what the plan could mean for the people who live here. Rachel.
Yeah, that's right. Those researchers at Ohio State say that by the end of the century, here in Central Ohio, our summers are actually going to be feeling a lot more like Arkansas. They're going to be hotter and they're going to be more humid. Our cooler months are going to feel more like the Carolinas. We're going to have wetter falls and milder winter months. That's why they put a plan together so the city of Columbus can start combating climate change. Part of Cannon Drive at OSU is being raised, so it will be high enough to protect Wexner Medical Center from a 500-year flood event, something OSU climatologists say will happen more often due to climate change.
And here in Ohio, it's these extreme precipitation, 2-, 3-, 4-inch rainfall events, and we're seeing, you know, things like I-70 inundated, different highways inundated at different times of the year, for sure.
The plan identifies the biggest impacts we'll see in our weather, like heavier rain, milder winters, and more 90-degree days in the summer, and outlines how people can prepare.
Individuals look at this to think about what the effect would be if they're renovating a home, or if they're going to locate a business in a place like a floodplain, if they're going to rent a property that might be impacted by extreme rainfall events.
The plan also outlines specific ways the city governments and businesses can help.
Do you have enough cooling centers for those that don't have adequate cooling? Do you have good distribution of fans and air conditioners?
They say we're already seeing the impacts of climate change here in Ohio, and while we can't completely stop it, we can make sure we're ready for what's to come.
So many things that we do now will impact ourselves for decades to come, and without accurate information, we're not going to have the ability to make wise decisions.
Now the public is invited to take a look at the report and weigh in on it until this Friday. After that, they will put together that final draft to submit to the city of Columbus and to the mayor. We'll have a link to that report if you want to take a look at it on our website. For now, reporting live in West Columbus, Rachel Penton, ABC6.